out with the new WBO Cruiserweight World Champion, Lawrence Okolie. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good, How are you?
Good, thank you, So I was looking on Google earlier, and you now come up as author, rapper, and boxer.
I swear.
Where would you rank them in terms of importance?
Son, you know, human being, then obviously boxer, author, and then musician.
Really?
Yeah.
How much time did you put into that book then?
Like a year or so. Mm-hmm.
And it's called Dare to Change Your Life. What's changed in your life since becoming world champion?
Since becoming world champion? That's only been a couple of months, so not much. Obviously, you know, we've been on lockdown and stuff, and you know, I haven't had people too much in and around, so you don't really feel it in that way. But obviously, it's a brilliant thing. But not much really, to be honest. I'm still in camp now, training for another fight. So it comes, the moment goes, and then you have to just keep it going.
I suppose your wrist is a bit shiny now since
you're going to be world champion as well. That's something. Yeah, shout out to Eddie for that. It's a brilliant gift. You know what I mean? Obviously, when I first started boxing, that was a real motivation of mine. You know what I mean? So it's good. Mm-hmm.
What's the plan at the moment then? Is it Dylan Prazovic, 14-0, 11 knockouts? What's your plans going forward?
As far as I'm aware to this point, that would be the one, because I do have a mandatory. I think because I won a vacant world title, you have to defend against a mandatory unless you can get unification. I've told Eddie and the team to go out and hunt for unifications, but for one reason or another, everyone's tied up or trying to go to heavyweight or calling out Jake Paul or doing whatever. So I'm just in a position where I might have to, I get to. It's a blessing to be a world champion. So I might have to do my mandatory and then hope that I'm able to win that and then end of the year have a unification.
So what's your time frame in terms of the next fight against Prazovic?
I want to be out in the next couple months. Do you know what I mean? Obviously I'm in training already, so if I could be out, you know, July, August, that'd be perfect.
Fight camp, is that something that you'd be interested in going to?
I would be. I hope there's fans. I think that there might be fans on that, so that would be good if there is. I'll do that. Wherever the next shows are, they are. Do you know what I mean? I'm all right with boxing with a crowd, without a crowd. It just is what it is.
Mm-hmm. And before becoming a world champion, you were adamant that you go to heavyweight eventually. What's your ideal route to heavyweight division? Are you still looking to become an undisputed champion?
Yeah, I mean, you've seen someone like Josh Taylor do it literally this weekend, and it's like, as much as being a world champion can't be taken away from you, becoming undisputed, he's arguably one of the best boxers that's ever come out of this country, and he's still going. Do you know what I mean? To be a four belt world champion in this era with that many limited amount of fights, with the record of the guys that he's boxed, you've got to be real about it. That's epic. So to sort of emulate someone like that, as well as the other legends that have come before, it'll be epic. Do you know what I mean? And I believe I'm in a weight class and at a time where it's possible.
What did you make of the Josh Taylor fight?
I thought it was great. I thought, you know, he did well. Of course, he's boxing another champion, so it's going to be back and forth and whatever else. But, you know, managing to score two great knockdowns and get the victory at the end of the day, that's just brilliant.
Mm-hmm. And we've just spoken off camera. You say, are you allowed to announce you're on the new ASPC game?
I'm not sure they haven't done it, so I don't know. But it is what it is.
Yeah, so if we are, obviously, if you're not, we'll put it out. But just talk to me about how excited you are to be in a boxing game.
Obviously, if we're allowed to talk about it, yeah, it'll be sick. It's going to be sick, obviously, you know. I've grown up playing games. I still play games now, on PlayStation, Xbox, whatever. So as a child, you know, I play Fight Night. I'm still playing it up until now, do you know what I mean? You've got the David Hayes, the Marta, all of these people on these brilliant games, and it sort of immortalizes you in a sense, at least in this moment, on this disc, on this platform. So to be in a position where I'm able to be in a game, it's amazing, do you know what I mean? And as a world champion, so it's sick. Hopefully that helps my stats, because I'm going to be very harsh on them if I don't get, you know, 90 or 99 power, at least in the right hand, so we'll see anyway.
Where would you put your stamina? What do you think that should be?
Oh, my stamina has to be up there as well. You've never seen me tired in a fight, do you know what I mean? Obviously, I've only done 12 one time, but in all my fights, I'm never the more tired person, just hoping for the best. So my fitness has to be up there as well. You know what I mean? It's hard. If I had my old stats, I'd be delusional and give myself 99 on all, but, you know, fuck it. And I'll be interested to see what other people's thoughts are.
Yeah. I just want to get your thoughts quickly on the scenario that's taken place with the heavyweights in the last week. Mm-hmm. Obviously, Wilder has won the arbitration, and it looks like Wilder Fury's happening for the third time. Are you surprised that this has happened in the last week? Were you expecting AJ versus Fury?
Yeah, I was. I was bang up for it. I was even looking to be on the undercard unless I felt like headlining my own show. I think someone knocked the door.
Were you surprised when AJ Fury is, you know, it's no longer looking like it's going to happen?
Yeah, no, definitely. You know, obviously, we're all talking about potentially boxing on the undercard of that or headlining our own show. So it seemed very real on our side. Obviously, there's a whole other side that, you know, it takes two to tango. So it was definitely a shock. You know, when I saw Fury announce it, I thought, this is done. Then the very next day, it's all up in the air. I thought it just couldn't be true. And it's, you know, very quickly, they've turned around a fight date and signed contracts, which to me is very weird. I don't know about the ins and outs of the boxing business in that end, but it is what it is, isn't it?
What happens if Wilder and Fury face off for a third time then? Do you think it's possible that Fury could overlook him because everyone expects him to win?
I don't think so. I don't think he's stupid, do you know what I mean? I think he's a very, in fact, I know he's a smart guy and he's a great boxer. So I don't think he can overlook him, but ultimately Wilder is still a world-class puncher, world-class boxer, still has a record of, I don't know, 40 with 39 KOs or whatever. So he's still a dangerous puncher and it's not a foregone conclusion.
Mm-hmm. And you've got a new addition here in the McGuigan gym, Daniel Dubois. Have you had a chance to catch up with him yet?
Yeah. We obviously knew each other from the Great Britain days. He's someone that, you know, I still support, and you know, we chat here and there. But now obviously we're in the gym. It's good. He's really growing as a person and as a fighter. So it's great to see.
Mm-hmm. Any sparring happened yet?
Not yet, and I'd like to keep it that way for as long as possible. If you see him on the pads, you understand he's a scary, scary puncher. But yeah, he's someone that I'm really excited for, and you know, I have to congratulate him. I have to congratulate Shane, because obviously Shane is a world-class coach. So congratulations to Dan for being able to secure someone like that, and then congratulations to Shane for being able to get someone with the potential that Dan has. And mm-hmm. if someone could bring out the potential in him, I definitely believe Shane's that guy.
What do you think he does if he's successful on June the 5th against Bogdan Dinu? Where do you think he goes?
I'm just continues to get better and better. He's still he's still very young, especially for a heavyweight. So I believe he'll continue to grow and progress. It's almost, sometimes I see Shane training him. I know it's only been a short space of time. And I have to whisper to Shane, slow down. You don't want to be showing him all that. Because it's scary, the potential that the guy's got, do you know what I mean? So I believe he has the potential to end up becoming a heavyweight champion. He's, as we said, only 23, 24. So by the time, you know, a few years pass, it could come sooner, but yeah, he's going to be dangerous.
And talking about having potential to become a heavyweight champion, obviously you've mentioned wanting to go there yourself. How do you think your style will suit the heavyweight division?
I think it'll suit it well, obviously, as long as I continue to progress in the way that I'm progressing. The reality is, you know, I'm not going to be the biggest, strongest heavyweight, so I have to be able to punch them hard and long. And know the exits to take and when to, you know, it's all the little nuances with my boxing styles that I think a lot of people don't get, that I'm always constantly thinking and adjusting when I'm in there. So if I'm in there against a heavyweight, there's certain stuff I will do and certain stuff I won't do. One is go into 50-50 brawls. Another one is, anyway, this goes on. I'm going to do my thing.
That's brilliant. So, last of all, mm-hmm. obviously you've mentioned the fight that's coming up this year. At the end of the year, who is it that you'd like? Obviously Breeders is there, you could unify the division. Who would be the second opponent if you were to fight twice this year?
Any of the champions, like, I'm not really fussed on which one. It would just be great to have two world title belts in my cabinet within the year, do you know what I mean? It would make me feel a sense of pride and satisfaction.
Mm-hmm. Brilliant, really appreciate your time, and catch up with you soon, hopefully at Fight Camp.
Thank you, champ.